Welcome back to LeetCode. In this video, we're exploring a fundamental problem in the binary trees. This problem is cornerstone for understanding deeper tree manipulation techniques and offers a great way to brush up your recursive programming skills. Let's dive in. So the question is, given the roots of your two binary trees, P and Q, write a function to check if they are same or not. Two binary trees are considered to be same if they are structurally identical and the nodes have the same value. So example one here is, like, given the two trees, we can see that the nodes have the same value and they're structurally identical. So this is true. In example two, we see that the structurally these are different, but nodes have the same value. For example three, we see that these two trees are structurally same, but the values of the nodes are different. So the output is false here. So constraints, the number of nodes in your both trees are in the range of 0 to 100. And then the node value less than equals the range of minus 10 power 4 to 10 power 4. Basically, the crux of the problem is it asks us to determine if the two trees are same. This means that every corresponding node in the two trees must have the same value and the structure of the trees must be identical. So the approach here is the recursive comparison. So the algorithm starts like this. First, we need to check for null trees. What it means is, like, if both nodes P and Q are none, the trees at this node are identical, then return true. Next, we check for inequality. So here, if one of the nodes is none, but not both, or the values of the nodes differ, then the trees are not same, then return false. So next is recursive descent. So here, recursively check the left children and right children of the current nodes. That is, we have to call this method like isSameTree for both left and right subtrees to compare the trees, and then we return the result of the logical end of these two recursive calls. This ensures that the both subtrees must be identical for the current trees to be considered the same. So let's look into the flowchart here. So first we need to check if both nodes are null. If yes, we return true. If no, we just continue, and then we check if is one node null or value differ. If yes, then we return false. And then if it is no, then we recursively check subtrees. We check the left subtree of both trees and same right subtree of both trees. And then we just do the end of the result, and then we determine if it is a false, then we should return false, and we should if it is a true, and then we should return true. So the dry run is, so the given, let's consider the given trees 1, 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2, 3. So the step one is to compare the root nodes 1 and 1. These are the same. And the step two, recursively compare the left children and the right children. Here both left children are 2 and 2 and the right children are 3 and 3. So these are same, right? So all comparisons return true here, hence the trees are same. Let's look into the code here. So we just start by checking both trees are null. So if they are null, it means that they are identical. So we return true. So our next condition is, like, if only one tree is null and other values are different, then they are not identical. So we return false in this case. That's what we're doing this here. So we're just checking if only one of them are null or the values are not same. And then the next step is recursively check if the left and right subtrees are identical. So we're just passing the left subtrees of the east tree and calling the same method, and similarly doing the right sub for the, and similarly we're doing for the right subtrees of the east tree. And then we're doing the logical end. So this gives us if both trees are identical or not. So that, let's look into the complexities here. So the time complex is O of n, where n is the number of nodes in a smaller tree, since we must potentially check every node for a given tree. This complexity, it's O of h. So the worst case scenario here is in an unbalanced tree where each node has only one child, the recursion depth equals to the number of nodes n. So this results in the space complexity of O of n, as a recursive call consumes space on the call stack. Best case scenario. In a perfectly balanced tree, such as binary search tree, the height of the tree is logarithmic with respect to the number of nodes. So that is log n. So consequently, the space complexity reduces to O of log n, as the recursion depth is limited by the height of the tree. Demo on conclusion. So I've got the code ready here. Let's try submitting this. So yeah, the solution got accepted. Conclusion: understanding how to compare two binary trees recursively not only enhances your grasp of the tree data structures, but also improves your ability to tackle the more complex recursive problems. Whether for the interviews or class assignments or personal projects, mastering this problem equips you with valuable skills applicable across numerous applications. Remember to practice regularly and explore variations of this problem to deepen your understanding and adaptability in solving the similar challenges. Thank you for tuning in to the episode of LeetCode. If you found this video helpful, be sure to give a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more coding tutorials and problem solving. So if you have any questions or solutions for the future topics, feel free to leave them in the comments below. Until next time, happy coding.